my body.
Losing weight can be one of the hardest things we can hope to accomplish. In theory, it seems like it should be as easy as putting on the weight, but in reality, that's just simply not the truth. Putting on weight is easy because it doesn't require much effort at all. Now losing weight requires much effort mentally and physically. It can be emotionally draining, as well as taxing on those around us. So why is it that we struggle so much with losing weight? Why is it that some of us can't stick to a plan we really want to accomplish? There are many factors that play along with the reasons we can't get to the goal lines. All of them are strictly mental, and if we can somehow get past the mental issues, then we can create the body we want to create. Sometimes we complicate things to the point that we just get tired even before we start. So the first thing you have to remember is to just start. No one is perfect and you will make mistakes. Start, then backtrack to see what worked and what didn't work. Here are 5 tips that can get you started on the right direction. 1. Knowledge is 10 times better than willpower. Understanding the fact that the more knowledge you consume, the more you will want to attain. Therefore, you will become engaged in the fact that you want to learn more about what you're trying to accomplish. By doing so, you will subconsciously keep yourself in the game much longer than you would by just saying to yourself, I'm going to win. So keep up with your research, dive deep into it and look at it from different angles. The different perspectives will keep you aligned on the path that you want to be on. It allows you to not get sidetracked and keep focused physically and mentally at all times. 2. Get an understanding of your body's complexity. Learn how your body works and the different mechanics behind it. Just don't follow that trend and learn about one or two things. By doing so, you will be able to decipher different tactics you're trying to utilize. The reason being is this: if you happen to try something and it fails, you have a better understanding of why it failed and what you need to do or try next. 3. Change your environment, not your behavior. Trying to change your behavior around a messed up environment is like trying to drive on a road full of nails. It just won't work. You have to change where you eat and what you eat. Don't go to a fast food place and accept yourself to eat healthy because you won't. You have to change your environment in order to stay effective. Sometimes this can be a bit hard to do, especially if you work all day and night. A simple way to get around this is by planning ahead. When you go to the grocery store, pick up things that are healthy to eat. Make sure you get some things that are not going to spoil, that way you can take them with you to work. As long as you stay a step ahead of the game, you will never fall back into the trap of bad eating and bad habits. 4. Choose friends wisely. Your friends can either make or break your efforts. If you have a friend who eats terrible and you're going out to eat with them, chances are you're going to eat terrible too that day. If you hang out with them frequently, then the habit will continue. I'm not saying get rid of good friend with bad eating habits, but what I am saying is be careful with the situations you get yourself with your friends that you already had, for example, like going out to eat. 5. Ask yourself why. Why do you want to lose weight? This is the question you should be constantly asking yourself. If you're doing this on a regular basis, you're going to stay on track more than if you didn't. Why? It subconsciously triggers the emotions behind the choice of making an active effort at losing weight. If you're not asking yourself this, you may or may not stay on track. Your subconscious may steer you off in a different direction after some time. Stay motivated and keep on the right path. Remember, take baby steps and be patient.